Only when I get done. Just hold on a little bit. Amen. The first song that was recorded was Moses' song. First one ever recorded. What Moses have to sing about? Moses couldn't even talk plain. Moses stuttered when he began to talk. Dude, I can't do nothing for God. You can do anything you want to do with God's help. Your own mind and your own person defeats you to what you can. Moses, I can't do it. God, you can do it. And he said, I can't preach, God, I stutter too much. You can't preach, and I'll anoint you to preach. And sometimes I still get caught in that old stuttering spirit. But greater is he that has called me than he that has bound me. You hear what I'm saying? Hey, Moses began to realize God gave us the victory. Pharaoh and his army was drowned in the Red Sea. And Moses, the stuttering man, had a song to sing. I don't care where you come from, what your background is. When you get excited what God's done for you, it'll stir up a song in your soul. Can someone say amen? I don't care what you've done, I mean what your handicap is. When you see God work for you, it'll stir up a song in your life. I don't care if you come up here with your hands withered, you got a voice and let it blow like a trumpet. I don't care if you stutter and stammer. Hey, let the Holy Ghost bless you and get in the spirit, now the flesh, and watch God touch our lives as we worship him together. Amen. Woo! Psalm Exodus 15 and 1, then sang Moses and the children of Israel this song unto the Lord. He spake saying, I will sing unto the Lord. You can't sing, Moses. You stutter too much. He must have forgot about it. When God begins to bless you, you forget about everything that binds you and hinders you. When you get anointed, you don't care who you got to fight. When you get anointed, you don't care how high the wall is. When you get anointed, you don't care if there's 800 or one coming after you. Because you know who's going to give you the victory. When you get anointed, you don't care if it's a giant 13 foot tall, or if it's Paul, amen, a little short man stature, having to face the devil, amen, the seven sons of Sceva come on to jump on the, amen, the devil whoop them. But when you got God on your side, you can whoop the devil. You hear what I'm saying? You are overcomers because we realize who he is and what he's done, and I can sing about it a little bit tonight. For the Lord has triumphed gloriously. And the horse and the rider has he thrown into the sea. I'm not going to go through all the song. But it rolled in so much. It got so anointed. He got so carried away. He said, the Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Amen. Mick then rode into the sisters. And Mary grabbed her timbrel and began to dance and began to shout the victory. And she began to sing. Your song will touch someone else's heart and they'll have a song. I'm here to tell you, friend. Amen. When you see what God's done for you, he'll give you a song. He hadn't done nothing for me. He kept you alive today. He saved your soul. You should have a song on your heart each and every hour. If you hang your harp upon the willow and you lose your song, you lose your joy, and you lose your victory. You should have a song of victory no matter what you're facing and going through, because you're keeping the right frame of mind. My God will bring me through. Amen. The song of Deborah. I'm coming to a close. Deborah sung a song. Isn't it something about how our ladies are so much more spiritual than men? Yeah. I made the statement, and I'll make it again. I'll make it till the Lord comes. God forbid that my wife should outpray me. Well, you're the preacher. Well, you're the man of the house. You should be the spiritual leader, the prayer warrior of your home. Help me while I preach. Come on, brother, say amen. Amen. Huh? If your wife's out praying you, you should dig in that altar and pray a little harder. Good preaching, Brother Vogan. Amen. This Barak had got a command of God to go fight the enemy. But he looked at Deborah, the prophetess. God can use women just as much as he can use men. I know some folks don't like women preachers, and I'm not up on women pastors because they should not usurp authority over men, and women are emotional. They can't handle a lot of situations like men do. They would break down under a lot of pressure, but God can use you just as much as he can use anybody. She was a prophetess. This man said, I can't go without you, Deborah. Will you go with me? And Deborah said, you know what? The Lord's going to give us the victory. It wasn't in the strength of that woman, but he had confidence that that woman had a touch of God. She was a prophetess. Said, you're not going to get the honor for this. The Lord's going to get the honor. Amen to God. Sesare was in the tent. And this woman, a woman took the tent nail and drove it through his temple and brought his head out there to the, amen, to Barak. And God gave them the victory over the enemy. And Deborah began to sing a song. Amen. The women are the first one to the choir. They're the loudest in the prayer rooms, even the night. They was down there praying it down while we had a couple of brothers out there trying to mumble around in prayer. And I'm not knocking your prayer. If you pray quiet, pray quiet. But them women, amen, that God were tearing down the prayer rooms of heaven tonight. And I'm praying and seeking God. We need some godly men in the church to have a song. We need some godly women in the church to have a song. And when you go to prayer, you can sing your song. When you come to church, you can sing your song. When you get the victory of the devil, you can sing your song. While you're fighting hell, you can still sing your song. Because we can't lose our song and hang our harp on the willow. Amen. We've got to keep singing the song of triumph. Well, brother, it just ain't like it used to be. Go ahead and hang your harp up if you want to. Well, I just can't feel God like I used to because your harp's on the willow tree. Get it down and begin to sing and watch God bless you right where you're at in your prayer closet and touching your life. I don't know about you, but I still feel heavy when I pray. I still speak in tongues sometimes when I pray. I still feel the anointing to preach from time to time when I preach. God's not dead. Amen. We need to have a song again in the church and realize, hey, he's waiting on us to get excited about him and give him all the glory. We're going to sing a new song. The song the angels can't sing. You know, they tell us that Lucifer was the choir leader and he had built-in pipes and organs, and he led the singing and the worship in heaven's ring. He come down to earth to turn singing away from God. But you know what? I've got a song that I'm going to sing. If I hold on to God and keep my hand in the hand of God, that Lucifer or no angel has ever sung. Woo! Only the redeemed. When I'm waiting to get there to sing, you better start singing before you get there. Huh? I can't tell you how many times before I make your way to the piano. I've drove down the road in miserable heat, working all day, soaking wet, painting, trying to follow the shade, trying to fix that which way I need to start in the morning that I can end in the shade in the evening, riding down all broken down mentally, spiritually, fighting hell. And a song come on the radio and it stirred a fire in my heart, and I begin to sing that song. Before long, heaven filled that old van and I feel a cool breeze of heaven and my hand begin to go up. Hey, you're not no singer, preacher. I was that day, praise God. Hey, I begin to sing the songs of Zion. It's the devil, I rebuke you in Jesus' name. I'm going to sing unto the Lord with all my heart, mind, and strength, because he gave me a song to sing that touched me at that moment. I'm going to tell you, you don't need to hang your harp on the willow, but get it down and strum it. If it don't sound good, it still blesses God. Amen. I get that little guitar over there, and I'm trying to learn the keys, and my fingers are too short to go around the bar. Amen. I said, John, we'll try to learn this thing and try to strum. I said, but my little short, fat fingers can't even get to the keys. So I just strum it anyways. Might not have sound as pretty as Bill's playing, but if I do it with a pure heart, God gets just as much glory as that as it does by the Bills. Huh? We're going to sing a new song one day. The angels can't sing. Revelations 5 and 9 says, they sung a new song saying, thou art worthy to take the book and open the seals thereof. Thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by the blood out of every kindred, tongue, and people and nation. Revelation 14 and 3 says, and they sung as it were a new song before the throne, before the four beasts, the elders. And no man could learn that song but the 144,000 and 4,000 which were redeemed from the earth. I know Jehovah's Witness thinks that's them. I was doing study and notes on that. I believe it's going to be everyone that has paid the price and totally sold out to God that's going to meet that number. It's not 12,000 tribes out of every nation. I know that's out of every tribe. But I've been grafted in. Amen. Brother, that's the 144,000. Yeah, it might be 12,000 in every tribe. But I mean to tell you, there's going to be a number that's going to have a song to sing when they get to heaven. He said, out of every tongue, out of every creed, and out of every nation. A song that the angels cannot sing. I don't know what it's going to be, but I want to be part of that choir. I can't sing, Lord, just put me on the back. I don't have to have the lead vocal. I don't have to have that perfect harmony part. Just fade me in somewhere. But I believe when we get to heaven, Brother Harmon, everyone's going to be able to sing like an angel. Huh? And we're going to throw our heads back and sing the song, worthy is the Lamb that was slain from the foundations of the world. I don't know about you. I may feel like I just got saved again and break down, start crying. Oh, there'll be no tears in heaven. He said he wiped the tears from your eyes. He may walk back there to you and said, you know what, son? You're in heaven now. You got nothing to cry about. Woo! Singing that song of Zion. I would God's people would come in here each and every service and be ready to sing. That we know, hey, I'm tired in body. How many times we come here and it's hard enough being a preacher seeing folks sit there and not respond. More or less being a singer. Anytime you try to do something for God, organize anything in the church, you easily get discouraged because you find out how many people really just don't care. That's just the truth. You try to do something, you find out who just read, they'd rather be home than they would do for themselves for the church. But regardless, when you come to church, if we could just come here and realize, hey, we've been coming here for 25 or 30 years, but help me to get some unction in my soul and realize I'm not singing to these walls. I'm not singing to these pews. I'm singing to Jehovah God that has redeemed my soul, and worship God with all that's within me and see if God will not but bless us again. Or we can keep our harp on the willow and sit around and weep and remember how God used to move and talk about the past. But I'm here to tell you, I'm not living in the past. I'm living for the present. I'm living for what God can do today for this church. And therefore, God, help me to keep singing the song. Can we stand our feet this evening? Don't lose your song. Young people, quit listening to the worldly music. You should have nothing on your iPod but gospel music. If you got worldly music filtrating that, you ain't right with God. Because you can't love God and the world at the same time. Clean it off. And listen to things that will bless your soul. I don't care what that girl's name is. I don't care that this girl's boyfriend cheated on her. He should have said no. All I care about is I got a soul and a family I'm trying to get to heaven, and a church I'm trying to be a blessing to, and I don't have time to get worldly things in my heart. We've got to keep fire in our soul and keep praying and keep going on and let the Holy Ghost bless us. But you can tell when people's songs die is when the world begins to live and Babylon creeps in. But help us to slay that giant and pick up our heart and get our song again and sing for the glory of God. But Thomas, you got a song for us tonight, don't you? You don't. I figured out the preacher like this. You said, preacher, I'll try singing tonight. Yeah. Oh, boy. I know he sings. I've heard him sing. He said, brother, y'all put me up front. I said, come on, brother, sing it. He can preach, he can sing, he can do it all. Brother Paris, if you sing, he'll sing. I'd like to hear that too. The duo. Yeah. Get one more, we'll have the three amigos up here singing for us. Hey, I'll join y'all. If y'all two come, we'll get up here. That's all. Huh? How many like to see that? Oh, I finally got some response tonight.
Amen.
My wife had both hands up. Come on, Brother Tom. Come on, Brother Patterson. Huh? Don't lose your song. Sister Valette. What's your nationality, your original nationality?
Yugoslavia.
I bet you go around the house singing in your native language, and it's a blessing to God. Huh? Then it might roll into you English. Huh? You begin to sing in English, go back to your native Yugoslavian language. And as God understands every language of every creed of every nation, the main thing He wants is a song from your heart. But John, you got a song for me tonight? You sing, I'll sing. Huh? You ain't scared, are you? A little bit. Oh, not of you, but me. I hear you, son. Savannah, you got a song for me now? I'm trying to get these that don't sing. I know Sister Vador got a song for me now. I know she can sing. Susie can sing too. I want somebody to sing that don't usually sing tonight to close this service out. Anybody gonna obey God tonight? Said, preacher, I'll sing. Huh? That don't usually sing a special song. Will somebody step forward? Be too shy. You want me to sing? Huh? Since you won't, I'm not neither. How's that? But if someone will, I will. Come on, who's going to be the first to say I'll sing? I'm waiting. We're waiting. Say, preacher, I got a song tonight. I don't even know a song to sing a song. To be honest with you. I don't even know a song by heart to sing. Huh? Oh, she gonna pick me out one? I guess I can follow a book like I follow notes, because I don't know how to preach neither. I done preached all my red hots that I could get up behind the pulpit and preach when you build new stuff. You know, these evangelists preach these messages 150 times. I can stand right there and preach it again, too. I got some I preach about 100 times. I can stand right there and preach, but you didn't hurt them. That's when you said, boy, that man can preach. I've been here going on 5 years. I'm digging now, boys. I don't know what I'm going to say next no more. The evangelists know what they can say next and know what the next point is. Y'all done heard all them. We get some new stuff now. Praise God. Got to have a song.